felicitation of Mr. Shashi Ruia, Mr. K.M. Sheth, and Mr. Shankar. Mr. Shashi Ruia is not in India, and therefore he apologizes, could not be attending this personally. Mr. Anshuman Ruia is there on his behalf, and he'll be accepting the fellowship on behalf of Mr. Shashi Ruia. So, starting this pleasant work, I would request the President and Mr. Y Nath to kindly escort Mr. Ruia to the dais, and Mr. Y Nath to please introduce Mr. Shashi Ruia.
A very good evening to the honorary guests, fellow members, and gentlemen. First of all, thank you so much for joining us this evening. I have the pleasant task of introducing Mr. Shashi Ruia. Not that he needs any introduction, nonetheless. Shri Shashi Ruia was born on December 23, 1943 in Mumbai. His father, Shri Nam Kishore Ruia, along with his family, moved to Chennai in 1956 to pursue his business. He set up businesses in automobiles, export of iron ore, and stevedoring. Shri Shashi Ruia learnt his first lessons in management under his father when he was sent to Chitradurg in Karnataka to look after mines. The lesson learned then proved invaluable later in his life. He studied from the University of Madras, now Chennai. He lost his father at young age of 25 years. And around the same time, iron ore export was nationalized by the government of India, forcing him to start life all over again. In 1969, he won the contract to build a breakwater at the outer harbor in Madras port. Starting his long journey as a successful entrepreneur, since then, he has never looked back. His brother, Shri Ravi Ruia, joined him in business, and thus Essar was born. The word coined by the father that combined the initials of the two brothers, S from Shashi and R from Ravi. Shri Shashi Ruia went on to execute contracts of all major ports like Goa, Tuticorin, Kakinada, and Mangalore. In 1976, he ventured into the shipping business, and Essar became the first private shipping company in India to own an oil tanker. Since then, both construction and shipping businesses were expanded. In shipping business, he has built a diversified fleet comprising of crude carriers, oil tankers, bulk carriers, and oboes. He also acquired high-tech ships like multi-support vessels, diving support vessels, besides offshore supply vessels to support India's industry. Shri Shashi Ruia took Essar into contract drilling business in mid-80s and established a formidable presence in this sector. The business built a fleet of land rigs, mobile rigs, offshore rigs, and drill ship. In order to lend stability to the group's business, he, along with his brother, chose to enter manufacturing sector. The two brothers set up the world's largest gas-based sponge iron plant in Hazira. When the economy was opened up in early 90s, it was as though the floodgates were opened for Essar. He and his brother steered the company to be the first private company to explore multiple business fronts. Essar became the first private company to set up the steel plant, the first independent power producer. It also was one of the first to start mobile telephony in India and the first to start the refining project. The telecom and business, which later joined hands with Vodafone, was valued at over $18 billion when Essar exited its 33% stake. In the decade beginning 2000, the Essar Group, led by Shri Ruia, entered new age businesses like BPO, technology aggregation, and expanded its footprint abroad by acquiring businesses in metals and refining. Today in UK, Essar's standalone refinery supplies 16% of the total transport fuel for the country. While the world questioned the success rate of mergers and acquisitions, Shri Shashi Ruia created one of the India's largest BPO company through 22 acquisitions, expanding Essar's presence to over 29 countries. The capacities of steel, power, and oil refining businesses were increased manifold. By 2015, Essar had a total revenue of $27 billion and assets in excess of $30 billion. Shri Shashi Ruia served on several important national bodies and industry associations. He was in the managing committee of the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, FICCI, an apex body of India's trade and business associations. He has also been the chairman of the prestigious Indo-US Joint Business Council and is a former president of the Indian National Shipowners Association, INSA. He is also a member of PM's Indo-US CEOs Forum and India-Japan Business Council. He was also the recipient of the Business India Businessman of the Year Award in 2010. Widely regarded as one of the architects of modern India, Shri Shashi Ruia is passionate about education and mentoring young talent. He is proud of all the employees of Essar who have done well for themselves under his leadership. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I invite Mr. Please welcome Mr. Anshuman Ruia.
Good evening to all of you. I miss the pleasure of being, I'm speaking on behalf of my father, so the speech is from him to all of y'all. I miss the pleasure of being with you personally today. I'm humbled by the felicitation and recognition, and I thank the Institute of Maritime Engineers of India for bestowing this honor on me. I seek the same with the humility on behalf of the colleagues at Essar Shipping. Shipping is close to my heart. It is one of the first businesses we started with. I have always believed that a buoyant shipping industry is critical for a growing nation like India, and that has a long coastline. India has the potential to become a leading maritime nation globally. We have the technical expertise and skilled manpower to manage this industry. The present government is also laying a lot of emphasis on usage of waterways. I must say that the Institute of Maritime Engineers need to be complimented for their selfless service to the shipping industry. Their commitment to the development and advancement of education and research in the field of maritime engineering is of the highest order, and their contribution to the near coastal voyage engineering cadre of India deserve to be appreciated. The Institute ensures a continuous availability of talent pool to the maritime industry. In my view, contributions from such an organization is a very important activity to ensure that the ships get maintained in good working condition and competent people are deployed to man the same. Before I end, I would like to wish the Institute of Maritime Engineers of India all the very best in all the future endeavors to promote the cause of the shipping industry. Thank you.